Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share another hair scarves compilation. It's been a few years since my last one, and all of the hairstyles in this video are different from that one, so be sure to let me know in the comment section which ones are your favorite. And all of the hair scarves that I'm using in today's video can be found in my online store, missysueshop.com. I will leave a link down below in the description box. Make sure to check it out. There's a ton of really fun hair accessories. Be sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing off a section of hair from the ears up to the top of my head and tie them off using an elastic band. Now I'm going to take my scarf and wrap it through the elastic band so the middle of the scarf is under the elastic. Then I'm going to take the ponytail and the two scarf ends and clip them out of the way. Now I'm going to divide off another section of hair starting at my ears and going up at a diagonal up to the top of my head. I'm going to tie off this new section using another clear elastic band. And now I'm going to let down the first ponytail and divide it into two sections. So each side has a section of hair and a section of the scarf. I'm going to bring the second ponytail up through the split and clip this out of the way. And now I'm going to divide off a new section of hair, starting at my ears again and working on a diagonal up towards the crown of my head. But I'm going to include the hair and the scarf from the first ponytail, and I'm going to combine it all together, tying it off using another clear elastic band. And then I'm going to let down the ponytail that is clipped away, and I'm going to divide it into two new sections. I'm going to take the second ponytail and bring it up between the split and clip it aside again. And then I'm going to pick up the remaining hair and combine it together with the two sections of hair that I had split and tie it all together using another clear elastic band. And now I'm going to let down the ponytail that is clipped up, divide it into two sections again, both halves with a section of hair and a section of the scarf. And then I'm going to bring the bottom ponytail up through the middle and clip it out of the way. Then I'm going to combine the two sections from the first ponytail back together and tie them off using another clear elastic band. And I'm just going to repeat these steps, working my way down the section of hair, so I'm always splitting the top ponytail into two sections. I'm bringing the second ponytail up through the middle, clipping it out of the way, and then I'm going to combine the two sections from the first ponytail back together and tie them off using an elastic band. And you can work your way all the way down to the ends of the hair. I always like to leave a little bit of a ponytail at the bottom. But then once I finish all of my sections of the braid, I'm just going to go back over and kind of pull on the sides to make each section a little bit bigger and more puffy. This will just help it show up a little bit better, and I think it adds a little bit more effect to the overall hairstyle. The next style is a high bun, which I feel like ends up being a favorite, so let me know in the comments what you think about this one. So I'm going to start by brushing all of my hair to the top of my head and tie it off with a hairband. Before the last wrap of the elastic though, I'm going to bring the ends forward and then pull the hair partway through the elastic to create a loop at the back. So now I'm going to take my hair scarf and wrap it through the elastic to the middle of the scarf. And then I'm going to take the ends of the ponytail and split them into three sections to use for a braid. I'm going to add the two ends of the scarf into two of the sections as well. And I'm going to braid these three strands into a regular three-strand braid. So I'm just crossing the side strands over the middle, alternating between the left and right side strands until the braid reaches the ends. And now I'm going to go back over the braid and pull on the edges. I'm not going to pull on the scarf at all, just the hair on the sides, so the braid is really wide. And then I'm going to tie off the end of the braid, including the hair and the ends of the scarf. Now I'm going to wrap the braid back over the bun that I initially created with the hairband. I'm going to tuck the ends of the hair under the bun and then use bobby pins to secure it in place. And it's okay if the ends of the scarf hang out. You can always tuck them up if that's what you prefer. But then I'm just going to make sure the sides of the bun are pinned down against the head, so the whole bun kind of sits flush with my head and there's no gaps or holes. And you can manipulate the bun however you need to, pulling on pieces to widen the bun in certain places while pinning down anything that is sticking out. The next hairstyle is so simple and quick and a really fun way to incorporate a scarf in your style. So what I'm first going to do is take my scarf and lay the middle over the top of my head, about an inch or so back from my hairline. I'm going to combine all of my hair together with the two ends of the scarf and tie it off with a hairband. And then I'm just going to tie the scarf in a knot over the top of the hairband, and this will help hide the hairband. Next up is the knotted low bun, and I'm going to bring all of my hair together at the nape of my neck to start the style. And then I'm going to divide it into two equal sections and tie off both sections using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to tie the hair into a knot. So what I'm going to do is cross the left side over the right, then tuck it underneath and bring it up through the middle. I'm going to pull the two sections in opposite directions to tighten the hair against my head. And then I'm going to cross the left strand over the right strand, then tuck it underneath, wrapping it around the right section and bring it out the top again. I'm going to tighten this section of the knot above the previously tied section, and then I'm going to wrap the ends around to the bottom of the knot and tie the hair once more. Depending on how long your hair is, you might be able to skip this last knot, but either way, just make sure the ends are pointed downwards, and then if you want them hidden, they can simply be tucked underneath the bun. And then I'm going to tie the bun using my hairband. So I'm just wrapping it around the base, and this will hold it in place for the most part. If any parts of the bun are sticking out, then I'm just going to slide a bobby pin into the bun to help hold it against my head. I also made sure to close any gaps in the hair around my crown. Then I'm going to take my hair scarf and wrap it underneath the bun. I'm going to wrap it up to the top of the bun and tie it once, and then wrap it back down to the bottom of the bun and tie it once more. I really like having the ends kind of stick out the bottom. I think it just kind of adds to the hairstyle and makes it look a little bit cuter. So for the next hairstyle, I'm going to start by dividing off a section of hair. I'm creating a part starting at my ears and going downwards towards the nape of my neck. Then clipping off the top section of hair, I'm going to take my scarf and place this right along the part line in between the two sections and then tie it into a knot at the nape of my neck. But now I'm going to let down the top section of hair and divide off a new section that I'll be using for the little half up portion of the style. So you can kind of gauge how much or little hair you want in this part of the style. I wanted to keep most of my hair down, so I divided off mostly hair from my crown, and then I'm just going to tie this off using a clear elastic. And on the second wrap, I'm going to make a little bun. So I'm only going to pull the hair partway through, and this will make the little loop. And then I'm going to take a small piece from the ends that are left sticking out, and I'm going to wrap this twice around the little elastic band and then tuck it back through the elastic band underneath the bun. And then of course I'm going to go back over the crown section and pull on really small sections of hair, just upwards and out. This will add some dimension to the hairstyle and make it look a little bit more casual and a little bit more lived in. For the next hairstyle, I've got my hair parted on the left side, and I'm going to be doing two Dutch braids. So I'm picking up a section on the left side near the hairline and dividing it into three smaller pieces. Since I'm doing a Dutch braid where the braid sits out on top of the head, I'm going to be crossing the side strands underneath the middle strand. I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid, so as I continue the braid down the left side of my head, I'm going to bring in medium-sized sections from along both the hairline and from the middle of the back of my head. And then once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to braid the section a little further down and clip off the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now with that braid done, I'm going to braid the hair on the right side into a second Dutch braid. So I'm picking up a section of hair near the hairline and dividing it into three smaller pieces. I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand and incorporate new sections of hair into the braid. I'm bringing in hair from along both the hairline and from along the middle of the back of my head. And then once the braid reaches the nape of my neck and I've brought in all of the hair from this side of my head, I'm going to continue the braid a little further down and then clip off the end of the braid. Now I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So what I'm going to do is combine the ends of the braids together and tie it off with a hairband. On the last wrap of the hairband, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to create a little bun. And then I'm going to take the ends sticking out the bottom and divide them into two sections. I'm going to wrap these two sections in opposite directions around the bun and then tuck the ends back into the hairband underneath the bun. And once the bun is done, I'm going to go back over both of the braids and pull out the edges so the braids are wider and look more full. And then I'm just going to take my scarf and wrap it around the bottom of the bun, tying it once at the top. And then I'm going to wrap the ends back down underneath the bun and tie the scarf once more underneath. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to start by dividing off two sections of hair on both the right and left sides of my head. I'm going to twist these together and then bring them around to the back of my head. And I'm going to tie them together using a clear elastic band. And then I'm going to flip the ends up and around the elastic so they're a little extra twisted. And then I'm going to go back over each of the two twists and gently pull on the edges to make them bigger so they show up better. Now I'm going to create the back twist. So first what I'm going to do is take the rest of my hair and divide it into two sections. I'm going to do the first part of a knot. So I'm going to cross the left side over the right, and then I'm going to wrap the left side up and around the right side. And then I'm going to combine the hair from the first twists with the section on the left side, and I'm going to start wrapping the two sections together. So I'm going to cross the left strand over the right while twisting the two individual sections in the opposite directions. And once the twist reaches the bottom of the hair, I'm going to tie off the end of the braid with a hairband. And now I'm going to go back over the twist and pull on the edges. This will give the overall braid a more casual look, which is what I'm going for each of these hairstyles. And then since I want to add in the scarf, I'm going to tuck the scarf through the hairband at the bottom and then tie the scarf around the hairband to hold it in place. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to combine all of my hair together at the nape of my neck. I'm going to twist all of the hair together and wrap it in a spiral around the nape of my neck. Then I'm going to take a hair tie and wrap it around the bun. And now what I'm going to do is push the edges of the bun down and then gently twist the whole thing towards the left so it stays wrapped around itself. And now I'm going to take my scarf and wrap it around the bun. So I'm going to first wrap it under the hair tie so it can't fall out completely. And then I'm just going to tie it once over the top of the bun. And then to add some volume and texture, I'm just going to gently pull on small sections of hair around the crown of my head. The next hairstyle is double French braids. I love this one. I think it's one of my favorites. So for this style, I'm going to divide my hair into two sections, a left and right side, and tie off the right side so I can braid the left side first. Since I'm doing a French braid, I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the left side of my head and split it into three smaller pieces. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the right and left strands. I'm also going to be bringing new sections of hair into the braid from along the part line and from along the hairline. Since this hairstyle is going to finish in a ponytail, I don't need to bring all of the hair into the braid. So I'm just going to repeat those steps, crossing the side strands over the middle strand until the braid reaches the point at the nape of my neck where I know I'll want my ponytail to sit. So then I'm just going to clip off the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to repeat the exact same steps and create another French braid with the hair on the right side of my head. So I've got my initial three sections and I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand while incorporating new sections of hair into the braid from along both my part line and from along my hairline, working my way down the back of my head until it reaches near the nape of my neck. And once the braid reaches that point where I want my ponytail to be, I'm going to pick up the first braid and combine it with the remaining hair that's left down. I'm going to tie off the ponytail using a hairband, and then I'm going to go back over the braid and gently pull on the sides to make it show up better. With a French braid, you have to be careful to only pull on the looped sections of the braid and not the pieces that are going into the braid. If you pull on these pieces, the braid will get loose and fall out. But once that's all done, I'm just going to tie my scarf into a knot around the hairband to hide it. For the next style, I'm going to do two Dutch braids on both sides of my head. So my hair is parted close to center, and I'm going to pick up a small section on the left side of my head and divide it into three smaller pieces. I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, so I'm alternating between crossing the right strand under the middle and then crossing the left strand under the middle. And after the first stitch, I'm going to start bringing new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm dividing off new sections from along the part line and from along the hairline until the braid reaches above my ear. I want to leave a section down to cover my ear, so then I'm just going to continue bringing in new sections from the top of my head until the braid reaches the back of my head. And now I'm going to braid the section a little further down without adding in any additional hair. And then I'm just going to clip off the braid so I can repeat the same steps on the opposite side. So I'm just going to pick up a small triangle-shaped section next to the part on the other side of my head and divide it into three smaller pieces. I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, working my way around the back of my head. I'm also adding in additional sections like before from along the part line and from along the hairline. And then once the two braids meet at the back of my head, I'm going to tie them together using a clear elastic band. And now that the two braids are done and tied off, I can go back over both of them and gently pull on the edges so the braids are a lot bigger. I always do this with my braids so they show up better, but it's definitely an extra step and you can keep them smaller if you prefer. And now I'm going to throw in my scarf, and I've wrapped an elastic band over the middle of my scarf. So I'm going to wrap this elastic band twice over the original elastic band and only pull the hair partway through to create a little mini bun. And then I'm just going to take the two scarf ends and tie them once over the top of the bun. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to combine all of my hair together at the nape of my neck and divide it into three equal sections. I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and right side strands. So I'm crossing the right strand over the middle and then crossing the left strand over the middle. And I'm just going to continue repeating these steps over and over until I've braided all of the hair into a regular three-strand braid. And when I couldn't reach my hair very easily, I pulled it upwards so the braid would stay straight instead of curving over my shoulder. And then once the braid reaches the bottom of the hair, I'm going to go back over the braid and pull on the sides so it becomes really big and loose and looks, you know, more casual, kind of the look we're going for all of these styles. And then I'm just going to tie off the end of the braid with a hairband. So now I'm going to grab my hair scarf and pull it through the hairband so it'll stay in if it comes untied. And I'm just going to tie the hair scarf once over the hairband. And then, so the style has more of a cool girl vibe, I'm going to pinch and pull on small sections of the hair around my crown just so it looks more disheveled and lived in. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to be doing two double buns. So I'm going to start by dividing my hair into two equal sections, a left side and a right side. Starting with the hair on the left side, I'm going to grab a hairband and tie it around the hair. On the last wrap of the elastic, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to form my loop, and then I'm going to take the ends sticking out from the bun and bring these around the left side. I'm going to wrap them twice around the hairband and then tuck the ends into the elastic underneath the bun. And if your hair only wraps once, that works just fine. You basically just want to use the hair to hide the elastic band. And now I'm going to take the section on the right side and repeat the same steps. So I'm wrapping the section with a hairband and pulling the hair partway through on the last wrap to create a loop. And then I'm going to wrap the ends counterclockwise around the hairband and then tuck the ends back into the hairband underneath the bun to help hold them in place. And then I'm just going to take my scarf and wrap it around my head, tying it at the top, and then just tuck the ends underneath. That wraps up today's tutorial. Be sure to let me know in the comments section which of the hairstyles was your favorite or which hairstyles were your favorite. Be sure to visit my store, MissySueShop.com, to find all of the hair scarves that I used in today's video. Be sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell, all the usual things, then you'll never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.